Yes. In this chapter, we are studying about the distinction between three states of matter in terms of moment of particles, related to the three states of matter with energy of moments of a particle in them, describe the changes of state using kinetic energy, boiling, melting, evaporation, sublimation, freezing, vaporization, fusion, condensation, deposition. These are all the contents what we are discussing.
Melting and fusion is the same, right?
Which one?
Melting and fusion is the same, right? Are the same, right?
Huh, we will discuss about that. And identify appropriate observable parameters in experiments. Collect data and make careful observations. Present the results in the form of tables. And consider the results using scientific knowledge and communication, these things. Now, yes, what are the characteristics of molecules? What are the characteristics of molecules? Let me know, what are all the characteristics of molecules? Last class we studied. What is molecule? You put in the mute, unmute it. What is molecule?
Molecules are very small particles of matter.
Okay.
Which has an independent existence.
Okay.
It is made of two or more atoms. So it
yes.
is stable.
Yes.
So as it is stable, it cannot take part in chemical reaction. So to take part in chemical reaction, it has to be be unstable by heating it or
okay.
high temperatures.
Yes. Now here the characteristics of molecules, they are very small in size. They have spaces between them. They are in constant motion as they possess kinetic energy. They attract each other. So these are all the four characteristics of molecules.
So this is the kinetic theory of matter, right?
Yes. Yes. Now, a molecule is composed of atoms and can consist independently and freely in nature. A molecule composed of one atom is called monoatomic molecule. Monoatomic molecules like He, helium, it's a monoatomic.
Carbon is a monoatomic, right?
Of course, carbon also. And neon, argon, so these are all the monoatomic. Yes? A molecule composed of two atoms is called diatomic. Di means two, dia. So two atomic, diatomic, two atomic, that is. So hydrogen molecule, H2, two molecules here. Oxygen, O2, nitrogen, N2, yes? And a molecule composed of more than the two atoms is called as a polyatomic. Polyatomic in the sense of, consider example, water. In water, hydrogen and oxygen, H2O. So two molecules of hydrogen and one molecule of oxygen, which includes water. Ammonia. Ammonia, have you know the formula?
Plus.
No, NH3, ammonium, ammonia. Okay, plus means ionization state, ions will be formed. So ammonia, NH3, nitrogen, one molecule of nitrogen, three molecules of hydrogen, which is called as ammonia. Carbon dioxide, CO2, one molecule of carbon, two molecules of oxygen, which is carbon dioxide. Next, the characteristics ones we can study. Molecules of size nearly 10 to the power of minus 10 meters. Very, very small. It is too small that it cannot be seen even with the help of microscope. So electronic microscope we have to use. So that much very small. Now, here to demonstrate that matter is composed of a tiny particles. How the matter is composed of tiny particles? After seeing up this, what you understood? What it is? Take a clean beaker, pour 100 ml of water. Yes. Now add 3 or 4 crystals of potassium permanganate in it. Potassium permanganate, 1 or 2 crystals, if you make it, lightly color will come. If you put it some more, little bit strong color. If you put it some more, it more strong. If you put it more, again more color. You can observe the color changes over here. Yes. If you place one particle of potassium permanganate, lightly color will be light color. If you increase the small content of potassium permanganate, slowly the colors also which is changing. So now in this experiment,
capacity of the container.
Yes, depends on the capacity, not the capacity of container. Container may be small or big. Water content.
Sorry, amount of water.
Amount of water. Say an example of 10 ml water only. All the beakers you put an equal amount of water. Fine. In the first beaker you can put it only 2 pellets of potassium permanganate. Second beaker 4 you put it. Third beaker 8 you put it. Next beaker 15 you put it. Whenever we are placing the amount of potassium permanganate, the colors are different. So which noted that each and every water content here, the water solution with potassium permanganate having a molecules of potassium permanganate, which is diluted over here. That's called as a solutions over here. The colors changes also we observe.
Yeah, like we are coloring on a book. Like first we color, like then we have again we like over like white.
Yes.
Over, like draw over it like more clear.
Yes. More depends on the color. Depends on the color. It happens. Okay. So this will be proved that the molecules of a size is very, very small. Now, in this activity, you can see that both are 100 ml. Yes, there are the 100 ml water in a measuring cylinder with equal amount of water.
It is very small because like when you put the pellets in the water, first time it only first time it's really light, like that's why it proves that it's really small.
Yes. Now add gently 20 grams of salt in water and stir it well. It dissolved evenly in the water. So we will notice that the level of water does not change. Again, still 100 ml only. If you put a stone, again we can observe there are the increment of a water level because the stone won't melt in the liquid. So we are placing salt, which is uniformly diluted entire the water. So the water level not increased. Now here what we understood, the molecules of a salt occupy the space between the molecules of the water. Okay. Now coming to one more activity. Spray a perfume in a corner of a room. You will find the smell of a perfume spread everywhere inside of the room. Yes. In a shortest time, it can come. This shows that. Yes, and this shows that the molecules of perfume are in random motion. So randomly enter the zone, we can able to get smell. Now, one more activity. Take a beaker, fill it partially with water. Add some lycopodium powder, which is yellow colored dust powder, lycopodium powder, also called jesh powder. In a beaker containing a water, stir it. Stir the content of the beaker with a glass rod. Take one few drops of suspension on the glass plate. Now place the tablet and illuminate with a table lamp. Observe the glass plate through a microscope. You will find the fine particles of lycopodium powder move rapidly in a random manner and their path zigzag. One more simple experiment. Take a beaker, and put one drop of ink. You can observe the ink mark will becomes randomly, it will be occupy entire the water molecules. It won't come in a straight line like a stone or something. Randomly it will be spread off, it will be occupy all the molecules. Yes,
when like while after painting, like when we put a brush
like the brush
into the water.
Yes. Now as you know that the state of matter into three types: solids, liquids and gases. What is solids? Solids generally, you know that intermolecular space is very very less, so between the space there are a lot of energy particles. Okay, when the intermolecular force is very strong and the kinetic energy is very less, the intermolecular space is reduced and matter exists as a solid. Say an example: ice cube, iron rod and some other same equal things. Ice cube also solid only, but the different character. If you give the heat, it will be melt.
Like bit watery, you know, watery. You can feel like water.
Yes, liquids. When intermolecular force between the constituent molecules is not much strong, and the kinetic energy is sufficient for the molecules to move to and fro, the intermolecular space is increased and the matter exists as a liquid. Okay, liquid, the intermolecular space is not that much strong, it's loosely bounded. Of course gaseous, you know that when the intermolecular force is negligible and the kinetic energy is very high, so matter exists.
Is it like not there?
Which one?
No, the like intermolecular force of attraction is like negligible.
Yes, it is negligible in the gaseous because randomly particles.
Not even with this present.
We can't say 100%. If you put it in a cylinder, there is a forces will be there. The same gas, if you put it in a packed closure container, again the forces will be there. Normal gases generally in the air, the intermolecular space is very negligible, right? There's a reason which is randomly moving. And the properties which decides the state of a substance are the mainly three. First one is intermolecular space. Second one, force of attraction between the molecules. Third one, the kinetic energy of a molecule due to their motion. Can you note it down, these three? Please note it down. We can discuss molecules of a solid. You know the solid, say an example, iron or any metals, wood, whatever the solids, you can take it. Once if you see the solid, it's very hard. Yes, right? Solids are very hard. Why it is very hard? Because inside of the solid, molecules are tightly packed. Very tightly packed.
Take the maximum amount of space. Maximum amount of space is filled with molecules.
No molecules space. Only. Yes.
No space are left free.
Yes.
Like minimum, the least.
Yes, so the this any solid which is made up of a tiny particles called as a molecules, these molecules are very small in size and they can be assumed like a smelly tiny rigid balls. So the separation between the two molecules in a solid is very small, it will be occupied. The molecules in a solid can only be vibrate to and fro about their main position, they do not leave their positions. Fine. The molecules in a solid are closely packed due to strong interactive forces between them. Between that, very strong interactive forces will be there. Yes. Next. Yes. Liquids. How the liquids? Each liquid made up of a very tiny particles called as a molecule. These molecules are very small in size and they are not in a rigid arrangement, little bit loosely packed. The intermolecular spaces in the liquids more than in the solids. It will be a bit more. So the liquid molecules can move about freely within the boundary of vessel in which the liquid is kept. If you pour a water in a glass, what will happen? It will be float. It will be float, right? Up to the top of the glass, it will be float. So the molecules are easy. You put the mute.
So can I ask a doubt?
Yes, please.
So I saw a question where in a moving car, in a container, water is kept in an open container, and water is like in a U shape.
Okay.
So the question was, what is the movement of the, like, what kind of movement is the car is having?
A car is moving. The top of the car, there is a water tank or kind of thing.
No, inside the car, there's like a water kept.
Inside of the car, they kept the water. Okay. Okay.
Small vessel kind of thing.
Okay. Like a water can, you can think.
Yes. And the water shaped in a U shape, like in a U shape kind of.
There is a U shape. Like this.
Say like this.
Fine. Yes, this is the container. Yes, there will be a U shape over here.
Yes.
Yes.
Water is immersed into like.
This type of thing coming. Okay. Yes. Yes. Tell me, what is the question?
Your question is, what is the motion, what kind of motion is the car? Comment about the motion of the car.
Motion of a car doesn't mean about the liquid shape. Let it be the movement of the car. For example, there is a car. Okay, this is the car. Or lorry or something, whatever. Here you placed a water tank. And water tank is filled. So this is the water shape.
Small can.
Okay, any can you can take it, and water surface will be this is the way. Generally, water surface is the way. If you put it in a can or something, take a small test tube, pour a water. Clearly, you can observe that water shape will be U shape. Fine. Now this car is moving. Once car is moving, water molecules are also moving along to the car. Yes. The momentum of a water particles is equal to the momentum of a car. If car stops, water molecules also will be stabilized. If car moves, again these water molecules also moving along to the car. Yes?
Yes, sir.
And yes, you got the point?
Yes, sir.
Next.
Not a particular motion, normal motion.
No, water molecules which is there in the inside of the container, obviously this water molecules having its own random motion, kinetic energy will be there. And whenever you are placing this water tank on the car, water molecules are also moving along to the car, even including the tank. If you stand over here, you're also moving. That concept only. Fine. If car stops, automatically water molecules will be there itself inside of the container. But inside of the water molecule, that energy will be still there. Without car moving also, the water molecules will be float. Yes? So that's the matter. Now coming to gaseous. Liquids we study. Next one is gaseous. And as we know, the gaseous, and like solids and liquids, gaseous are made up of a tiny particles called molecule. These molecules are very small in size and they can be assumed to be non-rigid balls, freely moving particles. The separation between the molecules is quite large as compared to the liquids and solids. Okay. The molecules in a gas are white and their portions are not fixed because the intermolecular forces in the gases are very weak. The arrangement of molecules in the gas, this is the way. Fine. Now, we already studied molecules and molecules models of the gaseous and water. Now, the distinction between solids, liquids, and gaseous. Yes, solids have a definite shape and a definite volume. Molecules in a solid are rigid. The molecules in a solid can only vibrate to and fro about their mean position. Here, we are discussing about solids, liquids, and gaseous. Already we discussed in class last year. And the molecules in a solid are rigid. The molecules in a solid can only vibrate to and fro and from their mean position. Only from the mean position will be vibrate. The molecules remain fixed at their position. The intermolecular forces are very strong. The molecule in a solid are closely packed. A solid cannot flow. It will be stable. Coming to the liquids, a liquid has a definite volume but not at a definite shape. Which container we are pouring, that container shape will be. The molecules in liquids are non-rigid. And the molecules in a liquid can move with the boundary of the vessels. Yes, instead of the boundary of the vessels only, it will be moved. Molecules do not remain fixed at their position. Automatically, there are the kinetic energies. The intermolecular forces are less stronger. The molecules in a liquid are loosely packed. Now, a liquid can flow. Yes, solid can't flow. Liquid can flow. Gas also can flow. Between the liquid and gas, gas molecules are non-rigid. It's freely movable. And the molecules do not move among their position. The intermolecular forces are very weak. The molecules of a gas is very apart. Fine. Now write a question. Difference between solids, liquids, and gases. Can you answer me through written? Okay.
Solid is not compressible. Liquids are slightly compressible. Gases are highly compressible. Solids have maximum density. Liquids have less density. And gases have least density.
Okay.
Solids are highly rigid. Liquids are less rigid. And gases are least rigid.
Okay.
Solids cannot diffuse. Liquids can diffuse. Gases can be easily diffused.
Okay. That's it. Very nice. Very good. Well efforts. Yes. And anything you found out?
Yeah, it's eight points. Around eight points.
All right. Next. Now, there are the few liquids, solids, and gases. You know, solids, ice, aluminium, silver, calcium, gold, iron, sodium chloride, sugar, wood, plastic, wax. These are all the solids. Coming to liquids, water, benzene, chloroform, oil, honey, glycerin, hydrochloric acid, nitric acid, alcohol, spirit, Dettol. Gaseous, steam, air, oxygen, hydrogen, chlorine, nitrogen, ammonia, sulfur dioxide, nitric oxide, helium, argon. Now there is a game. Yes, please.
like Dettol is a company or just like a name of a liquid?
Which one?
Like Dettol is a name of a company, right?
Dettol is a name of a company. Name of a company.
No, like, no, not like that. What I meant, like, I know that Dettol make like Dettol liquids, but I'm like, I thought it's like, it's like name of a liquid. Like, did they derive the name from a chemical liquid? That's what I
actually. Dettol is a company. You are right.
Yeah.
But it's a kind of a soap water we can consider.
Okay.
The chemical properties of a Dettol, you know that the soap formula?
No, sir.
N17H35COONA something. N17H35COONA. Okay. Fine. So the same formula will be to the Dettol also. Clear. These are the different forms. There are some chemicals they'll add.
Liquid form of soap.
Liquid is there. Soap also is there. Not Dettol soap is there. Dettol liquid is there. But generally consider for floor cleaning, liquid only we can use now.
Yeah. Like as I saw the name in the like between chemical liquid, had a doubt if it's like a chemical name or did they derive from that?
Ha ha ha. No. Now there is a fun game. There is a list of our solids, liquids and gaseous. Other than that, you should say one more 5 solids, 5 liquids and 5 gaseous. Which is not there, you have to say newly.
Cement brick.
Which one?
A cement brick.
Very good. Brick.
An iron box.
Whatever your home, everything is the solids only.
Not like that iron box, the iron box.
Can't you convert into chemicals? Lot of chemicals are solids, right? At our house, everything we are using solids only. Chemicals. Find out.